I searched the world, but it couldn't fill me. Man's empty praise and treasures that fade are never enough. Just started a series called Life Songs a couple weeks ago, or 2 weeks, because this is coming up on the second week. He's referring to the Psalms and the hymns that are in the Bible. And there are a lot of them written by David and a lot of different people, laments, all kinds of different things happen in there. It's a powerful time in the Bible, and it's a great conversation and things going on, and a great way for us to find God through the Bible, but certainly through other ways that he tries to communicate with us. Now, that's an interesting thought, in that there's a lot of different things. The Bible is God's word to us. God didn't just shut up after that happened. He continues to talk to man. He continues to deliver his message to many ministers, preachers, people walking the street. And how do we know that? The Bible tells us specifically that we, the disciples that came after him, will do even more greater things than Jesus did when he's here. And so how do we know the difference in what he's, the direction he's trying to give us? And those kind of things. And so how do we get those messages? Well, it's pretty interesting that almost everything that's around us is God trying to communicate with us. Many times we miss it because we try to find our message, the thing we want to hear in that message. So today we're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about some hymns. We're going to talk about songs. We're going to talk about the Bible. We're going to talk about God's message, the Holy Spirit within us. I hope you'll join us. It's starting right now. I said just started that series, and if we can't even talk about music, especially in the church music, specifically nowadays, and we look back in the 1700s, where many of the hymns that you heard, if you are a church person in church as a kid, and many of the hymns have developed today directly from Bible passages or from those hymns. Charlie Wesley, who was the brother of John Wesley, wrote thousands of hymns. In fact, he wrote 6,500 hymns over the year. You might recognize Hark the Herald Angels Sings from some Christmas play when you were a child. Well, that was one of his most famous, but 6,500. So, and I bring him up for this reason. He did something I think is great. Same thing David did. He celebrated with music and dancing in the streets. David got in a little trouble with his wife over that when he tuned her up for tuning him up about it. But in any case, Charlie Wesley would take and write these prayers, these hymns that wound up being hymns, but you read them, they really are conversations with God and prayers to God and description of his walk with God. And he would set them to music, the music of the contemporary music of that day. When you hear people complaining about hymns or the hymns in church today or the current contemporary sound of hymns, hey, you're in good company, because people complained in David's day. People complained in the first century. And certainly, you know, people complained about organs going in the church. They weren't going to go there anymore. Ministers saying, if I can't have organs in my church, I'm not going to preach in your church. I mean, there's always some controversy, especially around music. So he would set his prayer to the tune of the contemporary music being played in the bars. See, one of the people, when they heard the tune, to get their attention. It was his hook. We're going to talk about a hook in a minute, but it was his hook, and they would listen, and then they started hearing these other words, and they wanted to know what it was they were hearing. So it's pretty interesting that he did that back in the 1700s, and today we still see a lot of that contemporary hymns, one of the ones we're going to talk about today, that really refer to Bible passages and Bible happenings. And some of them are actual psalms from the Bible that we see that are written. My psalm, I love the psalm that comes to me is Psalm 123. I look to the hills. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. It's a great song. You can sing it. There's a song that they wrote it into a song. I look to the hills. Well, I can't sing it for you, but they wrote a contemporary song with the lyric of the Bible lyric, so that we would hear that contemporary music. It was the hook that brought us in, and then we would listen and we would be exposed to biblical knowledge and to scripture, and not even know it. So that's what we're going to talk about in the series that we're talking about. This is just kind of the introduction. I want to finish with today just talking about what that psalm means. That sounds very, very important. See, we look to the hills, right? And that when we first heard that, or when I first heard that, I thought, I look to the hills, that's where my help comes from. But that's not what it says. And that's what this whole series that I'm going to be talking about, which is a subset series that is motivated by hearing what Jeff says, and I refer to his sermons a lot. And I recommend that you go to New Hope's page and you watch those clips from each day. They're about a minute that look back into the message, but then go even deeper, sending you to see the whole message. And always one of the most dramatic, powerful pastors that I've ever heard in my 65 years, Pastor Jeff Cartwright at New Hope Church. Thank you for joining us today. I want you to remember when we are talking about looking for God's word and everything, that we have to make sure that, not that we think that we hear it, that we compare it to what the word says. The second message in this series is going to talk a little bit about that. Thank you so much for tuning in today. I'm so happy to have you in here. If you search the world and it couldn't fill you, that man's empty praise and treasures that fade were never enough, then you're in the right place, and we're going to talk about that. Have a great day. Remember this. Don't forget, Jesus loves you, and so do I. Have a great day.